Hi, my name is Robert Ahn. I'm from the School of Information at Berkeley. This is some work around advertising to smallholder farmers in East Africa. This is work with Michael Kramer and Julia Zane at Harvard University, and Matt Lowe's, who's at this nonprofit organization called Money. Sort of some background here. I think a lot of us in the room here know that smallholder farmers are this, in terms of like poverty targeting, smallholder farmers are a great group of people to work with that happen to be quite poor. And a major constraint that a lot of these farmers face is low food productivity. So from this graph on the right, you can see that yields for smallholder farmers has been, in sub-Saharan Africa, has been quite low compared to many other parts of the world. So a primary solution for this is greater technology adoption, specifically around fertilizer. So I worked at this nonprofit organization called One Acre Fund for a year. They provide financing and delivery for fertilizer and seed to over 400,000 smallholder farmers in East Africa. And the main problem they had were soils in this area were acidic. So there are these there's this fertilizer called agricultural lime that could be applied to soils to provide a 20 to 40% increase in yield. So this is a main source of like a smallholder farmer's family in terms of food and income. And so the proposition was, let's try advertising. So let's send text messages to their phones to see if this can budge technology adoption for these farmers. There are two field experiments we ran, one in Kenya with about 4,000 farmers. Almost all of them had phones, and we sent, there's a control group and there's a general group that got a general message and a targeted group where we targeted their geolocation based on agronomic properties of their geolocation. And we had another trial thereafter in Rwanda with 200,000 farmers in which we also tried to do this increased technology adoption, not only for the farmers who received the messages, but also farmers who didn't have phones. So really quickly, the results, we saw increase in lime adoptions of about 30 to 40% over control in Kenya, with estimated returns of about $95 to $138 increase in farmer incomes for every dollar spent on this SMS messages. So this is like a small number divided by a really small number, and you know, this is like a really high rate of return for this experiment. In Rwanda, we saw similar features, similar kind of increases in lime adoption, but we were also able to induce spillover onto the phoneless farmers to increase adoption for them around 13 to 30%. So the interesting thing about Rwanda is a large enough sample to start thinking about heterogeneity. So the first like angle of heterogeneity we looked at was, let's use previous like adoption figures to predict your like probability of adopting lime, like based on, we had about like 200 plus covariates to look at. So we threw it into some like elastic net random forest type thing, predicted this, interacted this against our treatments, and we're able to say like, oh, there's some people who like their probability of adopting prior interacted with the treatments in certain ways. So it kind of acted, you know, we could think about it as like a nudge versus some treatment messages that were very like for people who had no prior positive probability of adoption. So I call this like human, because this is how we normally maybe think about heterogeneity. We come up with one covariate and interact it with our treatment. Now, like kind of intelligent heterogeneity, thanks to keynote speaker here, there are these causal trees. And what we can do is basically take a few variables and partition that covariate space into buckets of people who have different treatment effects. 1 minute left. And so you can say, so you see when we, this terrible picture, but you can basically break things out into different districts for different like seasonalities and get, and I hacked some p-values there at the very bottom leaf nodes, but get these kind of these buckets of significance for different heterogeneity. The next kind of step, and I call this artificially intelligent because we kind of don't know what's going on anymore, but what happens is you take a bunch of these trees and stick them together, and you can estimate individual treatment effects, which is something kind of amazing, because I think when we have these randomized controlled trials, we often get these differences between treatment and control, but they're all this like distribution of who benefits and who doesn't. And this is where like this line of work is getting to. So, you know, we have this causal forest, and this is basically for the Rwanda data, all of the significant, not significant at p 0.05, effects, and then the blue ones are the ones that are significant. And if you drill down to that a little bit more, these are kind of the individual treatment choices. Sorry. Okay, done. Thanks.